Importing records from external sources is one of the most common ways of bringing in leads into Zoho CRM. Now, you might purchase your business leads, or you might transfer records between business units for cross-selling. The data importing feature comes in handy when you want to upload such records into Zoho CRM. With the latest UI revamp, data import and migration in Zoho CRM is a very clean and straightforward process, and there's more contextual assistance provided. Let's say you're importing several contacts into your CRM, and these contacts come with some additional information for which there are no existing fields in Zoho CRM. You can now create any additional necessary fields during the actual process of an import. With most information automatically captured from the source file by a CRM, there's actually very little left for you to do during an import. Let's look at how you can import records into your Zoho CRM. Go to the respective module into which you want to import your records. For this demo, let's look at how to import leads. So go to the Leads module, look at the top right, and click on the Import button and choose Import Leads. Here, as you can see, you have two options. You can either import leads from files, or if you're switching to Zoho CRM from another CRM and want all of your leads pushed here, you can select your respective CRM system from which you want to migrate and proceed further. You can actually watch a video on data migration for more information, but for right now, let's go ahead with the file option. Now, before we proceed further, let's look at a sample Excel spreadsheet from which we're going to import leads into Zoho CRM. Now, the first thing to notice is the field names. Your field names are basically column headers. Below your column headers are your list of records. Now, remember that mandatory fields like last name and company must have data in the spreadsheet in order for the import to take place. So now let's go back to Zoho CRM and choose the file. Now, your file can be in CSV, XLS, XLSX, or VCF formats. In the next screen, you can drag and drop your file or click Browse to upload the file. What you have here is a sample file that you can download and check for your reference. Now, once you've uploaded the file, the system automatically detects the appropriate character encoding based on your file characters. In case you want it changed, you can always click on the drop-down and choose another. Now, once you're done, click Next. When you have multiple page layouts, you need to choose one layout for the records that you're importing now. So here, let's go with the standard layout. Next, we're going to look at what you want to do with the records in the file. Here you have three options. You can add all the records as new leads, you can update existing leads only, or you can choose to do both, that is, add new leads and update the existing ones. I'm going to go ahead and click Add as New Leads. Next, in order to avoid duplicates, you can choose to skip existing leads based on their lead ID or email address. Let's choose email address for this demo. When you're done, click Next. Now here comes the most important part of data importing, mapping the fields. What you're essentially doing here is choosing the appropriate Zoho CRM fields for all of the columns in the file. So as you can see, all the column headers in the file are automatically mapped against fields in Zoho CRM. The data type and the format of the columns are auto-detected, thereby avoiding mapping columns to incompatible fields. There's also sample data from the file on the right side with the respective fields filled. You can always refer to them and confirm if the fields are mapped correctly. If you want to change the mapping for a field, go to the respective field in Zoho CRM. Click the drop-down and choose the appropriate field. Alternatively, if you choose to do the mapping manually for all the fields, you can click Reset Mapped Fields and do the mapping from scratch. It is important to make sure that all of the columns from the file are pushed to Zoho CRM. Here, you can check how many fields are mapped and how many are left unmapped. For those fields from the file that are unmapped, or for which there are no fields in Zoho CRM currently, you can create new fields from right here. Click Create New Fields, and in the Create New Fields window, custom fields are automatically suggested. You can edit the field properties and hit Create. you can click Apply Auto Mapping to automatically map the remaining unmapped fields in Zoho CRM with matching column headers if they're in the file. Now, when you're sure that all of the fields from the file are correctly mapped, click Next. We're going to assign lead source, lead owner, and tasks for all of the leads that get added through this import. Under Assign Lead Source, you could either click the dropdown and choose a lead source from the options listed, or if you have a column in the file for lead source, you could choose field mapping, and the lead source field will get mapped from the file in the same way as all the other fields. Under Assign Lead Owner, you have three options. You could click Users and assign all of the leads to one user from the dropdown, or you can click Assignment Rules and assign owner based on an assignment rule. Alternatively, you could again choose field mapping and the lead owner field will get mapped from the file. Finally, you can add a new task for the newly added leads under Assign Task. So let's say you want to add a task called Introductory Call for all of the leads. You can either choose it from the dropdown or create this workflow task right from here. You can also enable manual lead approval by selecting this checkbox. Now click Finished. And that's it. You'll get an email notification once the leads get imported into Zoho CRM successfully. Now, if you want to undo an import, you can go to your import history, where you will find the latest import entries. Move your mouse pointer to an entry and click Undo this import. And that's about it. Thank you so much for watching this video on data import, and I hope you found it useful. For more information, please visit www.zoho.com/crm/help.